Hi, good morning students. In this session we are going to discuss about personal management and human resource management and next topic of functions of human resource management. First one is personal management and human resource management. So what is personal management? Personal management deals with the organization employee relations or so purely deal with the only management, but human resource management deals with the manpower of the employees in the organization. Manpower means employees of the organization. Okay, first one is personal management, human resource management differences, comparison. First comparison, approach. In personal management, it's a purely traditional approach. But human resource management, it modern approach. It is a modern approach. Okay. In other words, traditional means oldest model. It's a newest model. Okay. In simple terms. Then treatment of manpower in personal management, treatment of manpower through machines or tools. In human resource management, treatment of manpower through assets. Okay. Then third point, type of function. In personal management, routine function followed by the personal management. In human resource management, strategic function. It is a strategic function. It means, according to Armstrong, we are already discussed in the first session, human resource management is a strategic management according to Armstrong. Okay, so that's why HRM is a strategic function. Basic pay, what is that? Basic pay. In personal management, basic pay through job evaluation. In human resource management, basic pay through performance evaluation. It is decided by the performance appraisal, increments, incentives, bonus, okay, other benefits based on the human resource management performance evaluation. Then management role, MGT stands for management. Okay. So management role, personal management role purely transactional. In human resource management, transformational. What is that? Transformational. It is transactional. Okay. Then communication. What is communication? Communication is a two types, verbal communication and nonverbal communication. We are already learned in previous semester in management subject. Okay. Management process subject. So communication in personal management, it is indirect. It means indirect. But human resource management, it is a direct communication to the management. Okay. Then labor management. In personal management, labor management, collective bargaining contracts. In human resource management, labor management, individual contracts. And next comparison, initiatives. In personal management, initiative piecemeal. What is piecemeal? Piecemeal means unsystematic or non-systematic. Okay, non-systematic measures. It is integrated. Personal management is a non-systematic. At the same time, HRM is a systematic or integrated. Management action. Next comparison. Management action. In personal management, management action procedure. Okay? Through procedure. Then human resource management based on the business need management action. Then decision making. Personal management can take a decision slow because of any person taken in the personal management decision, not a individual decision, it is a group decision depending on the one by one. That's why it decision taking slowly. But human resource management, only one manager are there in HRM. That's why it's a fast decision making system. Then job design. So in personal management, job design, division of labor. And human resource management, job design divided by groups or teams. Then next and last comparison, focus. Personal management focused on employee hiring, remunerating and training, etc. Okay, employee hiring means temporary basis. Okay, remunerating, training, these are the focused by the personal management. In human resource management, focused on manpower of the organization. HRM means it is a people management. That's why the manpower of the organization only. Okay, these are the difference between personal management and human resource management. Listen carefully, I repeat the difference between the personal management and human resource management. First one is approach. Personal management is a traditional approach and human resource management is a modern approach. Next, treatment of manpower. In personal management, treatment of manpower through machines or tools. In human resource management, treatment of manpower through assets. Okay. Then type of functions. Personal management is a routine function. Okay, personal management is a routine function, but human resource management strategic function. Basic pay. Personal management basic pay through job evaluation, but human resource management performance evaluation. What is that? Performance evaluation. Management role. In personal management, management role transactional. This is management role transactional. Human resource management transformational. Okay, next, communication is indirect in personal management. In human resource management, communication direct. Okay, direct. Then labor management, collective bargaining contracts. In human resource management, individual contracts. Okay, next, initiative, it means systems or measures. Okay, initiative. Personal management can follow the piecemeal system means unsystematic or non-systematic measure. It is integrated, it is integrated, it means systematic approach, management action procedure in personal management, and human resource management depend upon the business need. Okay, then decision making. In personal management, decision making is slow. Okay, slowly. Then HR management, decision making fast. Okay, job design divided by the division of labor in personal management. Job design divided by the groups and teams based on the as per the human resource management. Next, focus. Personal management focused on employee hiring, remunerating, training, etc. In human resource management, focused on manpower of the organization. These are the difference between personal management and human resource management. Okay, all clear? Next topic of functions of human resource management. Functions of human resource management. According to human resource management, functions are two types. First one is managerial functions. What is that? Managerial function. Second one is operational functions. In managerial functions, five main functions are available. First one is planning. What is planning? Planning about company having excess or shortage of staff. In case any excess of staff, the HR manager will planning the going to the shortage of the staff. Okay, in case shortage of the staff in the company, the HR manager plan the recruitment, start the recruitment process. Okay, so what about planning human resource management? Personal requirements means for job in the organization, then programs and policies, etc. Only for persons requirements, programs, policies, all are planned by the human resource manager. This is planning function. Planning function is the most important area in managerial function. Okay, that is called planning. Second one, organizing. Human resource manager organize all operative functions. Where functions are mainly two types. First one is managerial functions. Second one is operational functions. Organizing, human resource manager organize all operative functions by designing structure of relationship among jobs, personal, physical factors. Okay, so human resource management organize all operational functions or operative functions designing structure of relationship among the jobs, personals and physical factors of employees. Okay, then other functions also available in the organizing functions. Okay, first one is preparation of task force. HR manager daily given to the employees preparation of task force. Daily given the target, daily given the work, or weekly, monthly, depending upon the nature of job. Then second point, allocation of work to individuals. It is preparation of task force and allocation of work to individuals, not a group, not a teams, because of HRM focused on HRM job design, groups and teams. But HR manager allocation of work to individuals also, not a groups, not a teams, individual also, allocation of work prepared by human resource manager, and integration of the efforts of the task force. Integration means it's a systematic, independent. There is no problems in the to the HR manager. He is a purely integrated the efforts of the task force. Okay, then fourth point, coordination of work to individuals. Coordination of work to individuals. So HR manager coordination with work of individuals. These are the organizing function in management, managerial functions. Then third one is staffing. So in planning, organizing, directing, controlling, the four functions are worked by the people's only. People means staff. So staffing function also one of the most important area in functions of human resource management. So manage the planning, organizing, directing, controlling. So all four functions are managed by the staffing function. Okay, then the operations of these four functions depend upon the manpower. What is manpower? Manpower means people, peoples or employees, whatever it is. So human resource management is people's management. That wise, so the four functions depending upon the manpower which is available through staffing function, it involves managing organization structure through proper and effective selection, appraisal and development of employees. It involves managing organization structure through proper and effective selection, appraisal and development of all employees only. In the organization, the basic of four departments are available. First one is production department, sales department, accounts department, and finally HR department. The HR department function, one of the main function, staffing. So HR manager manage the all remaining three departments, that is production department, HR sales department and account departments also. So staffing is the most important function. And fourth one, directing. Okay, it is concerned with initiation of organization action and stimulating the people work. Stimulating means directing. Stimulating, directing, both are same meaning. Okay, the personal manager directs the activities of people of the organization to get its function performed properly. Any person worked in the organization, he is completely target, but without properly there is no use. But he can work short time, but with proper work it is useful to the organization. Okay, that's why the mention this point, its function performed properly. okay, mind it. And last one is controlling. Last managerial function of controlling. It is concerned with the regulation of activities. It is concerned with the regulation of activities. Occurrence with the plans. Occurs with the plans which the terms have been formulated on the basis of objectives. What is that? Objectives of the organization. Performance appraisal, critical examination of personal records and statistics and personal audit. Okay, these are the controlling functions in the organization. So these 5 points, listen carefully, I repeat the 5 points. So first of all, functions of human resource management are two types. First one is managerial functions and second one is operational functions. In managerial functions, planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling, these functions are managed by the human resource manager. Okay, first, planning is personal requirements, programs, policies. Okay, then organize HR manager. Organize the all operative functions, design structure of relationship among the jobs, personal and physical factors. And also organizing the some other points, preparation of task force, allocation of work to individuals, integration of efforts of the task force, coordination of work of individuals. Then third point is staffing. Manage the planning, organizing, directing, controlling. The four functions are managed by the staffing function. The operations of these four functions depending upon the manpower which is available through staffing function. It involves managing organization structure, proper and effective selection, appraisal and development. Okay, then fourth one, directing. It is concerned with the initiation of organization action and stimulating the people work. The personal manager directs the activities of people of the organization to get its functions performed properly. And last one, controlling. It is concerned with the regulation of activities in accordance with the plans which the terms have been formulated on the basis of objectives of the organization. Performance appraisal, critical examination of persons records and statistics, and personal audit. Audit means re-verification of human resources. These are the managerial functions of human resource management. Next topic, operational management. Okay, next one is operative functions. So first, in the operative functions, there is 9 points are there. First one is procurement. Procurement means collection of employees through recruitment. It is concerned with the obtaining of the proper kind and number of persons necessary to the accomplish organizational goals. It deals specifically with the such subjects as the determination of manpower requirement, recruitment, selection, placement and orientation. What is recruitment? At the time of HR planning, information given by the company, any excess or shortage of staff, HR manager will plan for recruitment. In case shortage of staff, planning for recruitment. After recruitment, some process interview and written examination conducted by the HR management, some candidates are selection. After selection, placements given to the new employees. In new employees, at the time of joining, introduced to the existing employees, and rules and regulations introduced to the new employee. That is called orientation or induction. We are already discussed in the previous session. Then second point one, development. What is development? Only human resource development. Only human resource development. Increase through training skills. Increase through training skills that is necessary for proper performance. That is necessary for proper performance. In this process, various techniques of training are used to development the employees. That is called HRM. Only for employees only. Okay. Then third point, professional development. This function helps to the employees with opportunities for growth. Only employees growth. Education and management training. Okay, employees with opportunity for growth, education and management training. The organization undertakes the sponsor their employees. For various seminars, trade show, corporate responsibilities. So these seminars, trade show, corporate responsibilities are maintained by the HR manager. This is also one of the professional development. Okay, then compensation. It means determination of adequate and equitable remuneration of persons for their contribution to organization objectives. To determine the monetary compensation for various jobs. That is compensation functions. Some benefits are given below from the compensation. The first one is working hours flexibility. As per the Labor Act, per day working hours is 8 hours per day. 8 hours per day. Okay, 1 week off for every 7 days, weekly 1 week off. That is the rule of as per the Labor Act. Then extension vacation, dental or medical insurance provided by the company. Education reimbursement for children as per two children only, as per labor law, two children's only. Okay, first two children's only. This is the operative functions. First one is procurement, development, professional development, compensation. And next one, performance appraisal. After completion of one year work done by the employee, the HR manager will conduct the performance appraisal for given to the employee of incentives, increments, bonus, promotions, These are the decided by the performance appraisal. These are the decided by the performance appraisal. Increments, incentives, bonus, promotions. Okay. Then next point. Maintaining good relation, good industrial relations. Maintaining good industrial relations. Reduce. So HR manager will maintaining good relations. Advantages of maintaining good relations. Reduce of strikes. Promote industrial peace. Then provide fair deal 2x and establishment democracy. These are the advantages of maintaining good industrial relation function by human resource manager. And next one is personal records. HR manager can maintain some records, that is training records. If given to the any person training, that records maintained by the HR manager. Achievements of employees and organizations also, achievement records also maintained by the HR manager. Transfers, employee transfers, one branch to another branch, one office to another office. Okay, then promotion records also maintained by the HR manager. PF, Provident Fund, ESA, Employee State Insurance, TA, Traveling Allowance. These are the records maintained by the HR manager. It is the most important function. And next one, personal planning and evaluation. Employee performance. As per the performance planning and evaluation, HR manager can maintain employee performance, practice personal audit, morale survey and performance appraisal. As per the personal planning and evaluation, HR manager conduct the employee performance, their practice, audit, moral survey and performance appraisal. These are the maintained by the HR manager. Then ensure legal compliance. Working conditions, working hours, OT. What is OT? OT means overtime. Any person can work more than 8 hours per day, it is treated as a overtime. Okay, more than 8 hours in a day. Okay, minimum wage, taxes. HR manager maintain the tax. What tax? Only PT, it means professional tax. According to Indian Act, professional tax will pay only 200 per month. Any person can take a salary 15,000 or more in a month. 15,000 or more per month, not a yearly, per month. Okay, and other allowances. Okay, so these are the ensure legal compliance functions. So listen carefully, I repeat the points. First one is procurement, second one is development, third one professional development, compensation, performance appraisal, maintaining good industrial relations, personal records, personal planning and evaluation, ensure legal compliance. These are the functions of human resource management. There is mainly two types of functions of human resource management. First one is managerial function, second one is operational function. Managerial functions are planning, organizing, staffing, controlling and directing. Then operative functions are procurement, development, professional development, compensation, performance appraisal, maintaining good industrial relations, personal records, personal planning and evaluation, ensure legal compliance. These are the functions of human resource management. Okay, thank you.